Hey YouTube, Rook here from Rook Geek Goodness, my little channel web for all things geeky and cool. Welcome back to the channel, guys. Welcome back to an inscription unboxing video. In this particular video, I'll be looking at the September 2021 Geek Fuel subscription box. Now, I'll let you guys know right out the gate, this is my last box I'm doing with Geek Fuel for September 2021. There's a lot of problems that happened getting this particular box. It was about 3 weeks delayed. They said because of shipping reasons is why it came in late, probably tacking it on to COVID most likely. But it's kind of odd that we've gotten boxes with a normally timely manner for Geek Fuel for the last 4 or 5 months with no issues. But now this particular box caused a problem. And to me, that's part of the reason why I have concerns with Geek Fuel. There's more reasons that I want to change subscription boxes that I want to deal with. Geek Fuel just really didn't get the job done for me. I'll talk more about that in a separate video. But before I get started, 2 points we have to talk about. Point number one, I want to thank all my viewers and subscribers who follow me on YouTube, follow me on social media, and continue to support this channel. But if you're someone new and never watched any of my videos before, please give this video a like at the bottom of the page. I want to get at least 10 likes for this video. I hope you can click that like button for your boy Rook here. Point number two before I break into this bad boy here is I do these videos a little bit different than anybody else on YouTube. Meaning I take the different approach when I do the unboxings, when I look at it from the perspective of someone who's brand new to subscription boxes. Like they've never opened a box before in their life and I have no clue what the theme is, if it's looked, you know, if it's hooked thematically with something else, what the IPs are in the box. I go completely blind every single time I do an unboxing video because I want to be surprised, just generally surprised when I crack into these boxes. Again, your typical packaging we've seen for Geek Fuel before. This was left out in the rain. They just left it like halfway down my driveway, which was kind of rude. So the box looks a little bit more beat up than your traditional box. So I've already cut the tape here. I'm going to peel it towards me and show it to the camera before I have a chance to see anything. That's why I usually do these particular unboxing videos. I'm going to move my turntable away so it's out of the shot. So let's peel it towards me. I got my knife, my scissors over here in case I need it. So you get a first look before I even get to see what's going on in this box. So this is what the box looks like when you crack it open. We have our literature right here. We usually put this aside and don't focus on that yet. We'll come back to that. That's how I usually do these mystery box openings. Again, we always have wearables. I've talked about this many, many times. This gets extremely old. I do my wearables. If there's any t-shirts, I usually do them for normal size t-shirts because I wear large, normally $15. That's the value I put on these shirts. I'll talk about value at the end of the video. So here's the shirt here. It looks to be some type of gaming shirt. Yeah, Fellowship, so it's a kind of a take on Zelda with the use of Lord of the Rings. So it's Lord of the Rings themed with a Zelda motif. I'll get an up-close shot of the shirt so you can see what it looks like. I do like the flavor. I think that's a very cool approach to take it. A Zelda-like, a Lord of the Rings sort of approach. I do like that. Next thing here, again, there's always 4 items in the box. I don't know why they do this. I'm still confused by this to this day. We got here DC Detective Comics complete covers. So I took all the covers for DC Comics here. This looks to be probably, I want to say silver, maybe a Silver Age here. It's a little tiny book. Price point for this is listed at $12. So this has a price point MSRP of $12. Again, I'll showcase a little bit of pages here. They're showing just covers for DC Comics, complete covers. That's what this is all about. Just in a pint-sized little kind of booklet that you can hold. I do like the idea, but I don't know why they would give this to us now. Not quite sure the reason for this. Let me know in the comments. Next, they always talk about pins. That's one thing that Geek Fuel is known for is their pins. This looks like a Pizza Hut box right here. Again, 4 items. Don't like it. Don't like the approach. I'll talk more about that in another video. So this is a Book It pin. I don't know why we have something that looks like Pizza Hut saying Book It. No clue why they did that. It's called Pin Pals, but it looks like a Pizza Hut box that you would get your Pizza Hut pizza in. That's what it looks like to me. Let me know in the comments section why it's Book It. I'm not sure the reason why they're taking that approach. Maybe you'll tell me in the literature. We'll get to that shortly. So, little pin. Last item in this box here, let me close her up here for, again, product placement, as I always do, because I always talk about that for you guys. Let me just close the box, put it back down to Geek Fuel so you can see the product placement, which is not a good thing. So let's open it up. This is a Harry Potter item. This is a plushie. You can hang it. This is a legit item. This is a branded Harry Potter item. This is not a Geek Fuel item, I don't think. And this is the Harry Potter version. I don't know if there's different variations. We'll take a look at that shortly. So Harry Potter plushie. Again, not the best things I've seen here. This is why, one of the reasons why I'm getting away from Geek Fuel. This to me really doesn't designate a $25 box. Yes, the value is there, but this seems extremely weak to me. And maybe it's just me, but this seems very lazy. Let's crack into the literature here. We have Hogwarts Hobbits and Heroes Literary Edition, Geek Fuel, right here. They tell you about everything in this particular box. If you open it up here, let's take a look at it. It looks like all the items, which what everybody would have gotten. Not a big fan of that. I do like to have some variety in my mystery boxes. I don't know why they don't put different things in the boxes. It's, again, how they take their business model. I'm not sure why Geekfield takes this approach. But let's take a look at all the items here. Of course, there'll be B-roll inside everything here so you get up-close shots of it. So the big item here, the Harry Potter item, is Harry Potter Q-Pals plush. They listed as $20. I can see this is a $20 item. I have no problem putting it $20 for that. It looks to be just Harry Potter with no other variety of it. The shirt here, they have its 8 bits to rule them all, exclusive t-shirt. This is a Geek Fuel branded t-shirt. They put the price point here at $25. Again, my price point is at $15. So in my eyes, you're looking at $35 between the shirt and the plushie. Next item is the DC complete covers, which is, again, this guy right here, they had it listed again at $12, which is what the MSRP listing on the actual item is on the package. So we had 20, 15, plus 10, 45, so we have $47 total right now, my personal opinion. And this was DC Complete Covers Volume 1. It's called a mini book, which I can see that. And you can cut this stuff out and do a BAM thing on the side. There's a little cutout. You can see it around the edges here. So you can cut this thing out, I'm guessing, and you can, I guess, you know, do something with this. I'm not sure exactly what you would do with it. And then you get the Pin Pals Pizza Hut sort of themed Book It pin. Looks like what they're talking about here is enjoy this month's exclusive pin depicting the ultimate book club for kids. Every gold star was one step closer to night out with family and friends. So I guess the idea is that if you got a gold star when you're doing your reading and stuff like that, they'd bring you to Pizza Hut. I think that was the approach you're taking. They have it at $10. I would think it's $10. So about a $57 box. We'll call it $60 to round up the numbers here. But again, my personal opinion with this box, this just seems a bit weak to me. I don't like what they did here. I don't like always getting four items. This to me is very, very lazy. It's a lazy way of doing design and marketing and putting these boxes out. That's why I'm switching companies. And again, Geek Fuel, September 2021 will be my very, very last mystery box opening with Geek Fuel. We're switching it up, getting a new box in a few weeks to do something completely different. I've done this company before. I'm hoping they change their business model, change how they're doing things. But that will be in another video talking about my thoughts and my experiences with Geek Fuel and what I'll be doing in the future. So I do hope you like this video, this unboxing video of September 2021 Geek Fuel Mystery Box. Give this video a like and comment page. Click that all-important subscribe button. When you subscribe to the channel, click the bell icon to be notified of the latest videos. And of course, last but not least, there's windows over here to watch more of my content. Take care, guys. See you next video. And bye-bye.